So I have a piece of fruit here now, and I will place it in the circle to act as an offering. So how do you know that it works? Many people ask me. Well, this fruit here has an energy. So if you feel it, you should feel that there is some energy, some life force in it. It's not very strong, it's actually quite weak, because the fruit is not very fresh. But still, it has some energy. And if all goes well, this energy should be taken by the spirits which are invited. It's also very much helping them to come closer to us, because this energy is a very heavy energy, much closer to the physical world. It has a little bit of life force in it, so it allows the spirit to come closer to our world, to come into our circle, into our dimension. And to be able to give it, I first have to have it. So it is not just about like putting things in the circle. It is about this has to be mine. I first have to claim it. This has to be mine to do with as I please. So I need to have kind of a dominance or an ownership of it energetically. And doesn't mean going to the supermarket and just buying it, but also energetically buying it. So I need to make this mine by becoming one with it. So this Kiwi and I start out as two very separate energies. He does his own thing, I do my own thing, and we have no claim on each other. So this Kiwi first has to accept me as its master. So first thing is I open up myself to the Kiwi. And the Kiwi can then see like, okay, you're a human, I'm a Kiwi. You are the stronger being and the more complex being in this interaction. So the Kiwi will start changing its energy to correspond to me. So if I feel the Kiwi again, it's still the same Kiwi, I should be able to feel this energy at almost twice the distance. Because the energy is now attuned to me, it is now, instead of radiating energy on its own frequency, it is now radiating energy on my frequency. So I will be able to pick up its presence from a longer distance. So once I've done this, and I make sure that the Kiwi is indeed my Kiwi, then I can offer the Kiwi. So in the same way, you cannot just sacrifice anything or anybody. It has to be, in a way, a sacrifice from you to somebody else. So the energy of the Kiwi, I now, in a way, make available to the higher powers, to the spirits. So the spirits are here, they can see me in this ritual space. So what I do to make it available to them, I need to place this Kiwi in their world. So symbolically, you can do this by placing it on the altar. And so energetically, you do it by making the energy a little bit higher. You put it halfway into their world so they can reach it. So I take the Kiwi, and I try to feel its energy, and invite the energy of the Kiwi to become a higher energy, to become more like a spirit. Then I place the Kiwi on the altar. And then it is simply a matter of waiting. Because, as we know, in the beginning the energy was quite strong. I could feel it here. And if the kiri is accepted by the spirit, the energy will start to diminish. And it can take some time, up to 20 minutes, for the energy of the sacrifice to be absorbed by the spirit. Often also in this period, when the spirits are absorbing the energy of the sacrifice, their presence will be more easy to feel, because they're drawn closer to our world, to our dimension. So you will get the feeling more strongly that you're not alone in this circle, or not alone in this place, but there's actually other powers there. So in this case I'm making a very general invitation for whatever spirit wants to come and have the kiwi. You could also do it much more specific. You can call upon spirits. You can pray to spirits prior to making the sacrifice. So to make sure that the right spirits are making attention, are paying attention to the space. So for instance, if I want this kiwi to be eaten by a saint, I would make a prayer to that saint. Or in this case, I want it to be eaten by a power animal. In this case, I see a salmon would be interested. So I pray to the salmon. Aho! Great sister salmon, be welcome in the circle of your friend. Partake of the sacrifice I have prepared for you, so you can be with me and your other friends here in this circle of beauty and harmony. Ho. And such an invitation can be done for many types of spirit, to invite them into the space, and also to provide the spirit with the energy it needs, the strength it needs, to work on our dimension. It's a little bit like having, for a spirit to come and to try to work with us, it's a little bit like coming a long way, having to travel across the ocean, and it's very hard if you have to bring all your tools with you on the airplane, because you can't bring metal, you can only have 20 kilos. So it is nice if you have local tools available for you to work with. That's basically what the kiwi is. I'm making local energies which belong to this dimension available for the spirit, so they can use them to perform a healing with. So I will now test again to see if the sacrifice has been accepted. I can actually not feel, I very barely feel the kiwi anymore, but only it's very close range. So that means that pretty much all the energy in the kiwi has been absorbed by the spirit. So it looks like our invitation works well. So, now we have a guest. We have a spirit in our circle. Our guest has been fed. So now we can talk business, and I can explain to the spirit what I would like to do, and the spirit can explain to me what it would like or what it would need. So to do this, I will start to try to make contact with it. And it is a lot easier once you have created a good space to meditate, because there won't be energies coming from the outside into your circle to disturb you anymore. It's also a place of safety, so you can relax much more easily and go into deeper meditations. So I relax myself, open myself up to make contact with the salmon. And in this case, there is very little that the salmon actually would like require of me to do. The servant just told me to lie down and let him do his work. So I guess that's what I'll do. And open myself up.